we're not only fighting for ourselves, but we're fighting for the future kids. We're fighting for them. We're fighting for their kids. It's not just us. The fire alarm went off. It was like, I remember checking my phone. And I'm like, oh, we have 20 minutes left. Like, let's go. And like, I was sending, like, I was airdropping, like, Valentine's Day cards, like, to all these kids. And we were all laughing, having, like, the best time of our lives. My friend Kiara calls me, and she's like, it's a shooting. And I'm like, no, it's not. Like, people told me it was the lockers. And then she calls me again. She's like, it's a shooting. Like, you need to run. And then, like, I start running. And I'm like, Kiara, like, I'm going. And then, sorry. Like, I saw all these cops coming into my neighborhood, and then that's when they told me the guy's outside, like, the shooter's outside, like, to the back entrance. I heard this guy describe how, like, he acts, and I was like, it's Nicholas Cruz. Like, I knew it before he even said his name. I'm like, it's Nicholas Cruz, I know it.
Yes, the event was sad. Yes, the event was tragic, and it was negative, but we're gonna turn it around, and we're gonna make it better, because that's what they would have wanted.
Julian and I have been to our state representatives, and now we're going to Washington, to our federal legislators, hoping that they can finally hear us out.
It's harder to like deny it and to make excuses when you're seeing us face to face.
This isn't just about our school. It's not. It's about every single place that you can go to and not feel safe because gun violence. Our school gets more attention because of our demographic. Like, we are a dominantly white school, and we're rich Republican. Like, and that's not fair because places like Chicago and Baltimore and Detroit, like, they this is every day for them.
They had gun control and they're instantly like, oh my God, they're taking away my gun.
I'm the child of a gun owner. Like, my mom owns guns. And like, oh, that's okay. Like, she's trying to protect her home. But to a certain extent, like, assault rifles, that's a no. She doesn't need that.
When everything first happened, I feel like those who weren't in the building, who witnessed it firsthand, they were still traumatized. They weren't ready to speak, you know, the next morning about it. They were grieving. I'm not gonna say a lot more, but differently than others. It's time to hear them.
The faces that you see of the like Never Again movement, they're not the only ones that went through it. Yeah, that's like, it's like that.
We're 3,000 kids.
We're not forgetting, especially us, we're not forgetting why we're doing all this. It's not just for these 17 angels, because obviously it's for them, but it's for every single family victim, anyone affected by gun violence. And I just don't want them to forget that we're not just gonna go on Twitter all day, gun reform, gun reform, gun reform. No, because we have a purpose behind it, and it's them.